Hey everyone, I'm Duke. Welcome back to Dokapon Kingdom. This is the same stream. I'm just kind of splitting it up just to make things a little easier for the YouTube watchers. Because I realize that a 3-hour video can be kind of daunting for people. They might not want to sit through the whole thing, and they might, you know, not want to worry about losing their place when they come back. So I'm just going to split it up a little bit. Hello, Sarah. Oh, she was just saying hello because it's a new video. But of course, this is the same session. Alright. So yeah, even if I didn't get a sword or a shield, he would have given me both when I got here. I think they're both pretty crappy, though. And his attack just randomly rose. That happens sometimes, I'm not sure what causes that. Dang, he might not make it to the castle at all. Be a bummer for him. Child show voice? Wait, why is Scarlet complaining? Oh, so she's actually fighting Helen now. Interesting. Alright, well, let's see how this goes. Oh. Bad move, Scarlet. Or wait, is that Helen? Dang. She got wrecked. I forgot you can play pranks on people when you kill them. When I played this with my friends, we were never, like, super competitive or anything. We kind of left each other alone and just did our own thing. But we probably missed out on a lot of the fun stuff you can do to other people. Alright, so what did the king give me here? Let's see. Oh wait, wrong thing. What do I want? Data? Yeah. Info. Yeah, he just gave me a knife, which isn't a great weapon. I probably want to go to the store at some point. Maybe sell some of the stuff. See what the slow spell does. Lowers a target's SP temporarily. I guess I can just use that on anyone who happens to be on the map. I'm not sure. One. Great. Well, I can get an item. Which, I don't know. This is the point where, when I played my test game, I started getting my ass royally handed to me. I'm a little scared to fight enemies with the crappy equipment I have now. But of course, I'm going to have to eventually, or else I'm never going to level up and I'm never going to get anywhere. However, for this turn, since I'm right next to the item space, I'm going to go ahead and go here and see what I get. Magic mirror. Interesting. I wonder if that defends me from magic or something. So close. You are playing around too much, Ajax. You should just go to the... Yeah, there you go. Good job. Welcome. Yeah, I mean, if I kill someone, I'm definitely not going to choose forgive. I will be counting on you. I don't know. I might actually do that. Yep, we're all here. I might have actually done that when I was playing with people, because, like I said, we were all way too nice to each other. Your journey will begin here. He twisted. Mario Party is the friendship ruiner for us, because all of my friends hate Mario Party except me. This game wasn't a friendship ruiner because, like I said, we were all way too nice to each other. We were playing it more as a co-op game, and it didn't really work like that. Although this game would be cool if it had, like, a co-op mode, where you were all teaming up to fight the monsters and stuff instead of fighting each other. Alright, so in order for you to beat each chapter, you will need to defeat some big monsters and clear the chapter event. No roughhousing, be nice to each other, yeah. Well, I'm not going to take you at your word on that one, King, sorry. Just a reminder, whoever has the most money will be the next king of Dokapon. Shouldn't it be whoever kills all the monsters first? I mean, why is money a more important factor in this? The hand of Princess Penny. Okay, I guess I didn't want to record that last line. Also, he said marriage again. What the hell is that? Now then, adventurers, good luck out there. A cure for cash. Yeah, Twisted, we kind of wish this game was co-op when we played.
Oh, no.
Why is Scarlet freaking out? She's doing better than anyone. I don't get it. Mario Party D&D. Yeah, exactly. That's kind of what we wish the game was. I mean, we still had a lot of fun with it. I mean, we played this game for many, many hours. Out of my way. And we did end up finishing. Yeah, when you die, you have to wait 3 turns before you respawn. It really sucks. Alright, do I see what this does? A mirror that nullifies shield magic. It breaks after the attack. Oh, cool. Alright, do I want to use my 2 crystal for anything? Probably not. Yeah, I'm not nearly strong enough to fight any of these big monsters yet. I want to be at least... probably a level below them. This is the lowest level I'd want to be before I actually fight them. But we'll see. Oh well, let's roll. I got a 2 anyway. So these are sort of like scaled up versions of the trash mobs. And then the big monsters are these guys, these big red ones. And these are really tough. Like, all of the monsters on the cities are tough, but these ones are especially tough. Alright, well, I forget if there's anything special about going onto an ocean square. I should probably work my way up to the weapons store. And Khan's Castle, I don't even remember what this place is. If you own this castle, you can get money and local items. Invest in it to upgrade the items. Can't be attacked. And Colosseum. Green Jr. stages a tournament battle. Just the item store. Oh, cool. It actually shows you what they have. That's cool. Do I have enough money to buy a better weapon? I don't think so. Well, I can buy a longsword. That would actually be pretty cool. Can I see what the items do from here? No, I guess I have to actually get there. All right, well, let's try to get a little experience and work my way up to the weapon store. Hopefully, I don't immediately die. Because it is... Wait. My battle.
Excuse me.
Oh, I see. It can be either 3 turns or 1 turn when you die. It's twisted.
My name is Leanne.
Okay. Is that all you're going to say?
I'd like you to deliver this item to a town.
Yeah. Why would I refuse? The faster you get it there, the better your reward will be. Well, I'm probably not going to be able to get there anytime soon because there's a monster sitting up. But that means I don't get a battle that turn, which kind of sucks.
Hey there! What do you want to sell?
No towns are free. It's private.
Which one do you want?
I don't think so. There might be free towns. I think they all have monsters on them. Thanks until we defeat the monsters, though.
Hey, thanks a lot. See you later.
Well, aren't you rich Uncle Money guy? Oh, I bet the CPU chatter is based on what face you give them. And she probably has, like, the pouty face or something, so all of her stuff is... complainy. I probably should have paid attention to what actual town I needed to go to. I'm not sure if I have access to that information from the screen.
Hello there. You can call me Risque.
Risque.
Look, sometimes in life you just have to fight dirty to get to the top.
So that went by too quickly for me to see it, but I think she had an option to pay that guy to attack someone or something. Something along those lines. Okay, so let's see. Drag Kusaya. Deliver this item to Usuri. Some people love it. The king is not one of them. Oh wait, will it punish me if I take this to the king or something? That's weird. I wonder why it says that. Alright, so where is Usuri? Let's have a look at the map. Yeah, so yeah, as you can see, Usuri still has a monster on it. level 7 monster, so it's probably going to be quite a while until I can make it there. Oh, he steals items or money from people. Right, but... Never really got why this game has 3 classes but can be 4 player. Well, aren't there more... Aren't there different classes you can get later on, Twisted? I thought for sure there was, like, a job system with different classes. I guess some of the towns are free because Sterling doesn't have a monster on it. Baxa Floy doesn't have a monster. Sidcap doesn't have a monster. But the big monster... See, that's the thing about the big monster. He summons the purple monsters. And he can drop them on these towns pretty much at a whim until we take him out. Alright. See if I can actually get into a battle and not die. Well, I could attack Helen. Probably not a great idea at this point. You get an item. Let's go here, I guess. Slowly work my way up. Okay, so it's just a level 1 rogue. This will probably not be a horrible battle, but let's see. Alright, can't predict anything because I haven't fought him yet, of course. Let's see. Probably no point using my charge attack until I'm actually fighting one of the big monsters. Wait, when did I get pickpocket? I didn't know I had that. Let's just attack. Should be sufficient. I'm glad I did not choose strike. Alright, so that battle went pretty well for me.
Won't be long now.
They're branching class paths, but it was odd that there were 3 to choose from. Or, yeah. You're right, it would make more sense with 4 players to have 4 classes at the beginning. Dang. Here's going for the throat. Jesus. Oh. I don't know if that was a good idea, Helen. That might not be, Oh, is she gonna be able to slow both of them? Oh no, just Helen, I guess. That'd be kind of messed up. Oh, she's going after one of the big monsters. See if she can pull this off. Dang, one hit? Really? Oh, I guess it didn't really have that much life. Oh well. So, since she killed one of the big monsters... she's level 5 already. I'm gonna have to do something about her. So she gets control of that town now. And it'll give her money... every week. Every 7 turns, basically. Yeah, even using that... Yeah, I figured she would give up. Even using that charge, she still barely did any damage to him. Oh, he still got experience even though she gave up. So he's going to prank her. Helen's name has been changed to Waste of Space. So that's one of the things you can do to your enemies once you defeat them, I guess. I might be able to... I wonder if I get to choose who I fight if I step on that space. It'd be interesting if I could choose to fight Waste of Space. I mean, because their hit points are so low. But if I end up fighting Ajax, I'll probably be in trouble. Yeah, look at his attack, 16. Good lord. Not a great idea. So I'm going to... use a slow spell on what's her face, on Scarlet, just to try to slow her down a little bit. I have a 53% chance to hit her. Yeah, so she dodged a spell, but I figured it was worth a shot. Oh, she's on timeout. You can't attack her. That's right. All right, well, let's move, see what happens. All right, lots of options here. I can go to Khan's castle. What does that do again? You own this castle. Can be attacked, so I'm not sure what happens if I just go there. bank space. Lets you collect taxes from or invest money in a single town. So yeah, this is where kind of the weird Monopoly Fortune Street aspect comes in. Because if you own a town and you land on the square, you can invest money into it and make it better. And I don't remember what all it can do, but kind of an interesting mechanic. Alright, so I can fight some monsters at sea, I can fight some monsters on land, and try to fight Scarlet. Still can't go to the weapon store. I don't think there's anything useful I could do at the bank at this point. Or, I'm not sure about Khan's castle. Yeah, the only person who owns a town right now is Scarlet. You can buy a town if you have 180,000 gold. let's fight a monster, I guess. Try to level up a little bit. What's this? Field magic? Yeah. I don't want to get away from Ajax there. Let's see what happens when I fight at sea. I'm not sure, well, I kind of want to stick to land, though, so I can kind of fight the same monsters and get an idea of how to approach them. Let's go here, I guess, and take a weird route to get there. Imp. Excellent, I attack first. Let's see. I'm just going to attack. The imp doesn't have much hit points, many hit points, so I probably don't need to do a strike. Miss? You gotta be kidding me. Well. Let's defend for now, I guess. Hope he doesn't strike. Yeah, just a normal attack. That's cool. Ooh, that was still kind of a lot of damage. This must be a nightmare. Boy, you're telling me, Ajax. Oh. Oh, shit. This might not be good. Oh, he's going first, too. Alright. So if he attacks me, I'm dead whether I defend, use magic guard, or counter. If he pickpockets me, not good, but I'm not going to die. If he strikes, I'm dead unless I counterattack. But really, I'm dead no matter what, unless he pickpockets me, or unless he strikes and I counter. That's kind of a bummer. I could give up. Probably be the smarter move. Because, I mean, what are the odds he's going to strike, really? Don't use strike unless you're going to lose. Well, I didn't know if I was going to lose or not, Private, because I didn't have the prediction screen with that enemy. I think I'm going to give up. My odds of death are just too high. You're the better man, Ajax. So we got zero experience, but he's going to rob me. Shit, he can take all of that? Wow. Waste of space. That's pretty good. So Scarlet actually took a town, which means she's probably going to rocket to the lead now. She just got 150,000 gold taking that town. It's quite a bit more gold than the rest of us have. But hey, at least I'm not in last. So it shows you this graph showing you your growth. As you can see, Scarlet kind of wrecked the curve there by making 150,000 gold. I think that'll about do it for this video. So, YouTube watchers, keep watching the tubes. Hitbox watchers, stay the course.